Okay, baby. You're hitting them corners fast. You need to slow this down. You understand? I almost spilled my yak on this $200 suit.
My channel. If you are new here, go ahead and hit the subscribe button because I'd love to have you a part of all of this. Also, go ahead and hit that bell notification so that every single time that I post, you'll be notified, which is every Wednesday and every Friday. Okay, you guys, I took some time. I took a little break. I'm back.
I took a couple, you know, I took some time off to rest, and now it's game time, bitches. You have no idea.
I say, it's game time. But the odds of me posting a second video this week are slim AFLOL.
And I'm just super excited. I'm just super excited to film. You read today's video titles. We're going to get right into it. So this will be the second episode I've done of this. I didn't want to call it a series because I have a tendency to put a lot of pressure on series that I start and I never actually like... I just forget them or I space them out too far. We're going to be doing another song analysis. And obviously you read the song in the title. But if you haven't read it yet, it's... Ocean Eyes by Billie Eilish. I know, obviously, I feel like a lot of people know Billie Eilish, but if you don't, she's one of the new pop girls. Well, maybe her sound is a little more pop. No, you know what it is? It's alternative. It's like an alternative kind of indie vibe. I mean, I think she's made some like pretty good music. I don't really know all of her songs like that. I might know, obviously, the one we're gonna talk about today. I know like Bad Guy and that really sad one, like,
I had a dream.
Like that one, and then you know some of the songs that gets overused on TikTok a lot. And I really like the song. I think it is beautifully arranged. It's one of those songs where I think that the artists and the production and everybody involved did a really good job not only conveying the feelings of the song with the lyrics, but I think with the vocal arrangements and the music and the production in general, they did a really good job creating this environment, this atmosphere that forces emotions that the artist wanted to get across. But I also think it does something to you that makes you feel that song as well. You know what I'm saying? So similar to the first video, we're going to listen to the song together and I will just pause it to just kind of make points and talk about what it is. Actually, you know what? Hold on. I put on the blue. I know it kind of, I feel like it washes out with these lights. What if I turn this off and we just do this? No, I'm kidding. The arrangement, oh, and if you listen to this with like headphones,
I've been watching you for some time. Can't stop staring at those ocean eyes. Burning cities and napalm skies.
Her voice?
15 years in the
sea. I'll say in a second. First of all, I want to say this, especially because I'm listening to a lot of songs by her. For me, it's just so interesting because her speaking voice is like nothing even remotely close to her singing voice.
Thank you, Ruby.
Who the fuck is Ruby?
I know that's not always the case with everybody. Like, I know that there are some people that have that trend, but her speaking voice is so naturally, like, so deep and, like, monotone, and just as she's able to get her voice up here, even obviously, like, it is produced. I'm not saying her voice is edited. I'm just saying that, like, it's just so crazy to me that she can produce this singing voice. But anyway, so in general, the vibes that I get from this song, what I think the song is about, Billie is in this relationship. It's a toxic relationship. It doesn't, you know, the song doesn't lean so much towards blaming it all on this person for being toxic or her maybe taking some of the blame for her being toxic in this relationship. I think just in general, it is a toxic relationship that she is experiencing. And so in this first verse, you know, she says, I've been watching you for some time. I can't stop staring at those ocean eyes. The ocean can be a very calming place. The beach itself, well, not just the beach, but I guess the ocean in general can be very calming. You know, if you're someone who likes water, the presence of the ocean, the big body of water, not thinking about how deep it is and how we haven't explored all of it. And so that can be kind of like nerve-wracking and even a little anxiety inducing, not that part, but just kind of like the romanticized part of the ocean. It's very calming. It's a very calming presence. Water's presence is very calming. But I think the interesting thing about the ocean is that it can be affected by a lot of outside forces that can disturb it in certain ways. If it's a very windy day, maybe it's gray skies, maybe a storm's about to hit, the water is going to be very choppy, the waves are going to be monsters, are going to be very aggressive, versus if it's like a sunny day, clear skies, the water's going to be very, like, you know, you might see a little bit of waves, but more or less going to be very calming, serene. You know, with the sun glaring down, you're going to be able to see, like, you know, how the ocean, you know, the sunlight will just, like, flicker off the ocean.
The word is glistening shorty. Damn.
It'll be a very different feeling. I feel like Billie knows this, and she also has related this to someone's eyes. You know, I think people say all the time, like, you know, the eyes are the window to the soul. I think people's eyes can be very telling. And I think a lot of times you can, obviously, you know, you can, right now I can be happy or I can be sad, I can be upset, you know, something like that. You can manipulate your eyes, but I feel like when you're genuinely feeling an emotion, it's, you can, might be able to manipulate your body language, you know, parts of your face, but I do feel like people's eyes are very telling when they are feeling an emotion. I feel like that analogy of the ocean and the eyes being two things that, like, are very telling of what's going on around them, I think it's a beautiful way to approach this song and a beautiful way to get this message across. So that's like an overarching thing. Within this first verse, I think she's comparing their relationship, or maybe even more her partner's actions, to being like very dramatic, very, what's the word I'm trying to think of? There's a lot going on there, you know, burning city, napalm skies, flares and whatnot, you know. I think that she is conveying that there's a lot of, emotion that's coming out. It's very chaotic, it's very in your face, there's fire and everything, it just feels very intense. There's a lot of intense emotions, so she's giving us some intense imagery, and she's saying that that is all seen in the person's eyes. So maybe they're not saying it, you know, she's not within this song saying how, like, you know, your words are like fire or your actions are like fire. She's saying that all these emotions I can see within your eyes. And then she goes into the chorus, no fair, but she says it a lot more beautiful than that. You really know how to make me cry when you give me those ocean eyes. I think that within her partner's eyes, she sees their emotions, and because she's so perceptive of, like, how strong they feel their emotions, how strong those emotions come through in their eyes, and how similar it is to that of the ocean, and the fact that, like, the ocean feels its environment's emotions very, very aggressively, and it's very displayed. That's the same thing that goes in her partner, and it affects her so much because she understands that correlation, and so it makes her emotional. But then the second half of the chorus, I've never fallen from quite this high, fallen into your ocean eyes. The concept of, like, falling, like falling in love, while their eyes tell stories of, like, emotion and pain and anger and all this stuff, she's also saying, like, but I am feeling these feelings for you, I am in love with you, perhaps, because of your eyes, because they are so full of emotion. I feel so connected to you from what I can see in your eyes. So there's, like, that duality of the eyes showing, you know, pain, anger, you know, kind of more negative emotions, versus showing, like, all these, like, maybe kind, serene emotions that make you fall in love, similar to the ocean. You know, you have those very bright, sunny days where the water is glistening, versus the days where it's about to rain and the waves are choppy and just all over the place. Verse 2. Second time she sings the chorus, it's the same as the first time. She was going to talk about the second verse. So it starts off, I've been walking through a world gone blind, can't stop thinking of your diamond mind. A diamond mind, I think, just means that she's very attracted to this person. Again, because of these things that she's able to kind of see into them and kind of, you know, get a better understanding of who they are. So they have these very emotive eyes, and now they have this diamond mind. Diamonds are very precious. Diamonds are beautiful.
Diamonds are a girl's best friend.
In general, she's attracted to their mind. It's just something that is so valuable, you know. So this person is very pensive and everything, and they're just a very intelligent person. So when she says, "I've been walking through a world gone blind," she is saying that this person's mind is so rare. She just feels like she just has been meeting a lot of people that just don't quite have that, like, that cognitive process that she's very much into. And next line, "Careful creatures made friends with time. He left her lonely with the diamond mind and those ocean eyes." I think, I could be reaching, because sometimes artists do just be throwing things in there, but I think she is describing herself. She is a careful creature, and she's made friends with time. Just saying that she has made friends with the fact that she has been waiting for someone like this, for a partner like this. But now that she's met this person, and they've been involved with each other, and they've had this kind of toxic relationship, but now he has left her with his mind, and again, these eyes. So this mind that she's so intrigued by and she's so interested in, and these very expressive eyes, he's now left her with that to just kind of think about. And I think we can all relate to that, you know, if you've ever been involved with somebody and they end up, you know, you all end up separating, or for whatever reason you guys aren't together anymore, you are kind of left with a piece of that person. You're left with kind of like their thoughts and everything, and like just the emotions that they would project onto you in either a good or a bad way. So I think actually that is that's a beautiful line right there. And you know what? It's funny. The same thing that happened in the last video, how I told y'all that obviously Human Nature is one of my favorite songs, but I'd never heard that part in the chorus. I'm looking at the lyrics on genius.com for the bridge, and there's parts of it that are like backwards, and I have never, it's basically the chorus backwards through like some ad lib. So we're gonna see if I can hear this. That's it. Before we get to the last chorus, which I don't have any comments about just because it's the same chorus we've been hearing, but I just want to hear it because I think her voice just sounds really nice. I have never noticed that. It pays to look at lyrics to songs. It really does, because I never have heard that. And I've always wondered what, like, were the sounds going on in the back, but it is her voice that they've kind of, you know, put that thing down, flipped it, and reversed it. It's her remnant of the and did that. That is so beautiful. Okay, last chorus. I love this song. We're just going to absorb it together. Said this before, I don't really have like any vocal training, any musical training, but I think just that like breathiness on a song, I feel like is very hard to hold for like those ending notes, you know, where she kind of drags out like the no fair and the I'm scared part. I feel like those would be fairly hard things to do with such a breathy kind of like quiet tone. And with the little bit of musical understanding I do have from watching actual professionals react to things like this, hats off, like, you have to give credit where credit is due. She has such an amazing voice sometimes, and I think that this song was released very early on in her career. I don't know if she wrote it or like how much involvement she had in the songwriting or the production, but her team, her, whoever's involved with like the creative process of this song, just hats off, because she, like, the sheer sound of this song, I think, is just so emotion invoking. Like, okay, let's wrap it up. So I like the song because, one, it's one of the perfect like sad songs. Like, it's on my mellow mood playlist, which if you want to listen to, I'll link it down below. But I love this song so much. I think it is so beautifully written. I love how it correlates, you know, the ocean to people's eyes. It's like I said before, I do think the eyes are very expressive and they tell a lot about somebody. They are the windows to the soul. And I think that the eyes, like I said before, are very telling of what a person is going through. I think you can see it a lot in someone's eyes. And I think you can tell a lot about somebody by their eyes. And it's the same thing to the ocean. You know, the bodies of water are so affected by anything that comes in contact with them, whether it be the environment, people, ships, animals. You're going to be able to see that within the water. So you always be able to see these things that have affected the body of water, similar to how you would see someone's eyes. And in this song, Billie is attracted to her partner because she does see this emotion. And yes, she has fallen very hard for this person because of the emotion they're able to see in their eyes, but it has also been kind of like the kryptonite to their relationship because, you know, whether or not this person means it to come out, I think that a lot of their anger and their emotions show through their eyes, and it has affected Billie in certain ways. At the end of the day, the eyes, like, the emotion that the person displays in their eyes, it hurts her, it makes her cry, she says in the chorus, and they just evoke such images of burning cities and napalm skies and everything. So it's a very beautifully written song, very well written, very well performed. I've actually never seen her perform it live, so let me know if you want to see me react to her performing it live, because I've actually never heard it live. If you want to see me do that, let me know in the comments down below. But I think that is all for today. I hope you all enjoyed. I have an idea of the next song I'm going to do for this series, but if you have any suggestions down below, let me know. And yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, be sure to give it a big thumbs up. Also, leave me a comment. What do you think about the song? What do you think about Billie Eilish in general? What do you think about my analysis? Everything you want to say to me, say down below, because I always respond to comments, so I'd love to talk to you guys. And again, if you are not subscribed, please go ahead and do so. I'd love to have you here, and go ahead and hit that bell notification so every single time I post, you'll be notified, which is every Wednesday and every Friday. I love y'all very much. Please take care of yourselves out there. Please be kind to yourself. Just do things that make you feel good. And yeah, that's all I'm saying on that. Do things that make you feel good. Point blank, period. Talk nice to yourself before you talk nice to anybody else, and I'll see you all very, very soon. Peace.